You've probably seen Egyptian mummies when you've been to museums, or you might have read about the discovery of some mummies, or maybe you've seen the movie The Mummy. But have you ever wondered how these Egyptian mummies were made? This is what today's video is all about. Hello, and welcome back to Wonders of Heritage. And if you're new here, I'm your host Maria, and this is a channel that's dedicated to stories about cultural heritage and heritage science. In today's video, we'll learn about the mummification process and we'll see how the Egyptian mummies were made. So let's get right into it. First, the body of the deceased was washed with water and salt. Then, the brain was removed using a long hook. This instrument was used to mash the brain until it was liquefied. The embalmers then turned the body face down to let the liquefied brain flow out of the body through the person's nostrils. The next stage involved the removal of the internal organs, which would cause decay if left inside the body. The embalmers made an incision in the lower left-hand side of the abdomen to open the body to gain access to the internal organs. They removed the liver, the lungs, the intestines, and the stomach. The heart was usually left inside the body, but sometimes the embalmers also removed the heart. Each organ was then dried and preserved with natron. Natron is a hydrated sodium carbonate mineral mixed with some sodium bicarbonate, sodium chloride, and sodium sulfate. Each organ was then wrapped in strips of linen and placed in its dedicated canopic jar. The lid of each canopic jar was sculpted to depict the heads of the four sons of the god Horus. Each son of Horus would then protect the organ in his canopic jar. The liver was placed in the canopic jar, whose lid depicted Imseti's human head. The lungs were placed in the jar with Hapi's baboon head on the lid. The stomach went into the jackal-headed jar for its protection by Duamutef. And finally, the intestines were placed inside the jar, whose lid depicted Kebesanuf's falcon head. With all the organs safely set aside for the sons of Horus to protect them, it is now time to care for the body. The embalmers cleaned the now empty abdomen and filled the body with aromatic spices like myrrh, cassia, and others. They added packs of natron inside the body and then covered the whole body with natron for up to 70 days. This process was in place to remove all the moisture from the body and prevent it from rotting. A dehydrated body could be well preserved without the risk of decaying. After the body was dehydrated, the natron from inside the body was removed and the body was filled with sawdust and linen to give it a lifelike shape. The next step was to wash the body, oil the skin to soften it, and cover the body in resin to prevent the growth of mold, which would hinder the preservation of the body. They also added false eyes and a wig and covered the mummy with jewelries before carefully wrapping the entire body in many layers of linen stripes. A face mask made to look like that person was placed in between layers of bandages that were wrapped around the person's head. This was done to make it easy for the spirit to recognize its body. After every several layers of wrappings, they used warm resin in between the layers of linen to help keep the bandages together. In between the many layers of linen, they also added small magical amulets and wrote magical words and prayers on some of the linen stripes to protect the mummy's spirit on its way to the afterlife. With this, the mummy was ready. And then it was placed in a wooden case or in a stone sarcophagus inside the tomb that would be its final resting place. Various items that might be of use for that person in the afterlife were also added to the tomb. This included furniture, clothes, and jewelries. Different pet animals were also mummified and placed in the tombs to keep them company in the afterlife. Animal mummification was very common in Egypt. Here's a fun fact about animal mummies. A catacomb of about 8 million mummified dogs was found next to the temple dedicated to Anubis, Anubis is a jackal-headed god associated with mummification and the afterlife. I will add a link to the article in the video description if you want to read more about these dog mummies. And let me know in the comments below if you know of any interesting facts about the Egyptian mummies or about the mummification process in ancient Egypt. So now that we have the mummy and it is well preserved for the afterlife, why is it that the ancient Egyptians went through all this trouble to prepare the mummies? They did it because they were mimicking the myth of Osiris, the god of the dead. Osiris was murdered by his jealous brother Set. And to make sure that Osiris wouldn't be brought back to life, Set hacked Osiris's body into pieces and spread them onto the land and in the Nile. The goddess Isis managed to find and reassemble the body parts, and this is how Osiris was magically revived and he became the god of the afterlife. The Egyptians believed that similarly to the reconstruction of Osiris's body, in the afterlife, all the organs would be reunited with their body and it would become whole again. I hope you enjoyed learning how the ancient Egyptian mummies were made. If you did, please give this video a thumbs up and subscribe for more fun videos about cultural heritage and heritage science. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time. Bye!